Welcome to part 3 of the Atlas Copco STa6000 tutorial. In this video, we will be using the STa6000 along with a PowerFocus SL controller and tool to verify the torque output on the tool and the controller are accurate. In part 4, we will do an actual calibration of the tool. First, we must set up a Pset for our tool that we are verifying. Using the ToolsTalk PF software, we are connecting our PowerFocus SL controller to our computer via Ethernet, but you could also access it through the network if it's already set up. That will be in another tutorial. If you are using a PowerFocus SL graph model, you could easily set this up on a controller using the keypad and color display. Once connected to the controller, we could set up our program. We are using a 1 Nm transducer, so we will aim for 0.9 Nm as our final target. Since we are using a power tool with a soft joint, we will need to do some tests to see how the joint will react. We set our first target to 0.4 Nm to start. We changed it from 0.5 off camera. We also turn down the speed and ramp speed to a much lower value so that we don't over-torque our transducer and we get better results. Press Store on the bottom right to save our changes to the controller. Now we will go into our tool configuration and set our tool to push to start. Your tool may be different if you have a lever start. Again, press Store to save your changes. Now that our Pset is ready, we will do a rundown on the soft joint with no transducer attached. As you see, we hit our mark of 0.9 Nm perfectly according to the controller. Back in ToolsTalk PF, we can view our trace. We hit our first target within the first 50 degrees of rotation, which is too soon. We don't need the power tool to ramp down to its final speed until the last 80 to 100 degrees, so we will adjust our first target. We set our first target to 0.82 Nm, according to the trace graph we see. Next, we will perform another rundown after saving the Pset. Now we see our first target right where we want it, about 80 degrees from our final torque. Confident we won't over-torque our transducer, we move on to attach it to the tool. Next, we must set up our STa6000 for the test we will perform. Since we don't have a wireless module installed, we will turn on our STa6000 and connect it via USB to our computer running the ToolsTalk BLM software. Once connected, you could double-click on the device in the left menu or click the Connect button on the top toolbar. Our STa6000 will now pop up. If you don't see your device listed on the side of the screen, make sure you have the target device set to your analyzer that you're using on the top right of the screen. Next, we will select Pset from the drop-down menu and create a new Pset for this demo. You can name it however you'd like. We are using a power tool, so we select that option. Once you hit OK, the Pset editor window will pop up. Here we will enter the same values we set on our tool Pset for the verification test. After that, we will set our batch size. We are using a batch size of 10. Hit Store and confirm to delete any previous stats associated with this Pset. Since this is a new Pset, there is nothing that will be erased. Next, we will have to add our tool. Back on the left menu, select Tool and then Create New Tool. Here, you will name the tool and enter its serial, so you can trace the test to the specific tool if you have many of them. Once you hit OK, you will now enter the specs for your tool. Next, we will specify which Pset will be linked to this tool. For us, we selected Pset 2 that we named Demo earlier. Select your Pset and then press Confirm. Click Store and you're good to go. You may now disconnect your STa6000 from the computer. Next on your analyzer, select Test from the menu. Then select Tool and confirm that the tool we created is selected. Press Menu and then Open, and you should see the Pset we created and associated with the tool. Hit Menu again, then Start to begin the test. As we do our rundowns, you will see the values displayed on our analyzer and the batch count up top too. After the final rundown, we have completed our batch. Pressing the up arrow and then enter allows us to add a note to this test. We add the note OK to signify that the test was a success. You could add multiple notes if needed. From here, we could view our results and traces right on our analyzer by pressing View and selecting which we'd like to see. Here we have our trace, which you can use if you don't have a ToolsTalk PF installed, or a graph model controller. Viewing the stats will display your max, min, mean, and other torque and angle values recorded from the test. Finally, we save our results. Now we can switch back to ToolsTalk BLM once we plug in our analyzer again. After connecting, we could open down the drop-down list and select Reports. Since we performed a CM-CMK test, we will select that option. Our report now opens for us to view. At the top, you can change the page number. All the info from the tool and transducer is displayed here, as well as our analyzer device info. Once we are happy with our results, we could save them to an Excel, PDF, or Word format and print them. If your analyzer is networked using the wireless module, you can print your results directly to a networked printer. Alternatively, you could select the results viewer and customize exactly which results will appear on your results sheet. If there is data not needed, simply remove it, or add more by using the arrows. Here we add transducer serial number, and we remove the job ID and tag ID. The top four options are always locked and can't be removed. We also removed the angle data since we were only interested in testing the torque for this demo. Once finished, hit OK and you'll see your results. The batch status will display not OK until the 10th rundown when the batch is complete. We removed our first result, which was a test, by unchecking it. Again here, we have many options for saving. We create a new statistic report with only the 10 selected rundowns, and again we could save and print this condensed version without all the graphs from the previous versions. This concludes our tutorial on verifying torque. In our next tutorial, we will show you how to change the calibration value of the tool being used. Thanks for tuning in. If you have any questions, post them in the comments, and be sure to subscribe for more product updates and tutorials from Flexible Assembly.